Yeah, what's good? It's your boy Kadillac Jackson, and I'm broke, nigga. I'm broke. Season 4, episode 2. And for the people that don't like seasons,
episode 23.
Well, Glenn,
moving right along.
It is your boy OG Sneakers, and I'm about to be broke for real because college tuition about to take all of my sneaker collection.
For real.
Hey man, it's like that in them streets. It's like that in them streets. It's your man Beard Jedi, aka I just got ousted, aka looking for a new church, aka the deacon without a flock. AKA somebody help me, AKA where the angels, AKA Iron Knight Tyson, and AKA the medicine most. This is Jack Swagless. This is Talkin Kicks season 4, episode 2. We in the building with the most dope family, the most shoe having family, the people who feet smell like old bus seats, the kick talkers. Say what's up. We're at Two Fly Souls. The talented misters in the building. Dun's Kicks. What's going on, bruh? Dun's in the building. We also have, they the only ones talking to each other. Sneakerholic B's in the building. One Leg Lister in the building. What's going on, brother? Pop Lewis. What's going on? Pop Pop is in the building. We also have, as I look down this list, Mr. Bear 76. GN happened to make it before the end of the show. Welcome to the party, brother. Baltimore Tay, a.k.a. Tay Baltimore, is in the building. Lars Young is in the building. OG Kicks, what's going on, family? Lars Young, again, is in the building because we missed you, bro. We're going to say that shit twice. Matter of fact, for good measure, Lars Young is in the building. What's going on, brother? QdaQueen is in the building as well. Who am I missing? Who am I missing? Hop Dog 18. For sure. For sure. Hey, Kadillac.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Kadillac Jackson.
Yes, sir.
I know that you're broke, but can you do me one small favor?
I can't donate to the offering this week.
Okay. Well, I mean, that's not my problem. I don't run the church anymore.
You goddamn right. You don't run the church no more.
You have to take that up with black ass African. But can you please like the damn video?
I'll think about it, former pastor.
Damn. No respect around this motherfucker. I'm still the choir director. You get no solo this week, bro. No solo this week, bro. Shit.
Well, looked like Ricardo Bonner slid in under the wire, brother.
Hey, what's going on, Ricardo Bonner? We also have Q Kerbo in the building. I don't know if that's an AKA name, if you had your side chick house, but what's going on, Kerbo?
And Big Hurt.
Big Hurt's in the building. Hey, look, bro. Big Hurt, before you post another chick with a hairy chest like that, I'm gonna need you to consult. I'm gonna need you to consult.
Put up like a
warning or something, bro.
Something, bro.
I mean, shit. DreDay Kicks. What's going on? Families in the building as well. That picture was terrible, bro. that picture was terrible. OG.
Mm-hmm.
QdaQueen's in the building.
Royalty. Royals.
Hey, we got to see QdaQueen kicking it. You know what I'm saying? She's doing it real big on the small level. She was out there with Damn D kicking in Chicago.
Wait. Before we go any further,
I don't
appreciate Damn D putting his hand all up on your head like, oh, thank this you. Real family. I was like, hold up.
We don't do that.
She didn't appreciate it either. Did you watch the video?
Did you see the eyes cut like,
yeah.
Nigga.
he almost pulled up a nub. I was like, shit. Who else we got in here? Jermaine Manning is in the building as well. What's going on? And Jamie White is in the building.
Sports Guy Q.
Sports Guy Q is in the building, man. We live, man. If y'all in here, y'all like the video. If you don't. But please let us know how we can get better. You know, it feels good to sit in this chair again. You know, Black Ass African came in and stole the show last week. And I appreciate y'all for inviting me back to y'all church. You know, hello, congregation. I'm a visitor here.
Two Fly Souls. What's good, family?
An official pastor.
God damn it. Y'all know how we do, man. We didn't do this last week. You know, last week's show, our first show back for the season, was a little bit weird, but we didn't do this last week. I want to make sure that we let y'all know, if you are looking to buy some shoes and you would like to get a discount, you can go to footagesociety.com and you can put in Talkin Kicks, TalkinKicks, and get 10% off. That simple. Them shadows, they got them. You know what I'm saying? You want some dope throwback kicks? They got them. You need a size swap? Holla at them. They might be able to help you out. Ain't that right, Jamie White? So holla at the family, for the society, our sponsor for another season. We rock out with them heavy. Y'all rock out with them too. Last I heard, you know, Nicole was out here in the Bentley. That's just what I heard. I heard she went to the DR and had a convertible Bentley on y'all. You know what I'm saying? So we appreciate y'all for supporting the family, for real. Real talk. All right, let's get into it. Y'all know what it is. It's hump day heat.
Can I say one thing before we get there?
Of course, brother, of course.
Hey, man, I know everybody probably in the family saw it on the gram, but, you know, we just want to take this real quick opportunity to say, you know, prayers and blessings out to Molly Marl and his family during this time. Brother, we posted up our pictures and everything for you. We're thinking about you. You know, I always say the hashtag, sometimes it's not about sneakers, and this is absolutely one of those moments. You know, just, you know, God's comfort with you and your family, brother. Respect.
Hey, absolutely, bro. Absolutely. We're going to do the hump day heat. We're going to roll through. OG's going to go last on the hump day heat so he can go first on the pickups, because we kind of gave him an alley-oop this week. Let him get this shit all off so he can have his moment. I'll go first because usually my shit is the cheapest. You know what I'm saying? That's what I do. I'm not embarrassed about that. I'm cool with the cost. I'm the undercost boss, a.k.a. Bishop Bilo. I'm fine with that. You're not offending me if you call me cheap. You know what I'm saying? You're not offending me if you call me broke. You know what I'm saying? And depending on who you are, and if you as tall as Big Hurt or you as swole as Big Hurt, I'm not offended if you call me a bitch. You know, I might let that shit slide. But if you come up in this motherfucker, you shorter than me, you call me bitch. We got the rumble, young man. For the hump day heat and the chat, make sure that y'all let us know what y'all got on. I went ahead and I wore the theme, by the way, for the week was red shoes. So either all red shoes or shoes that had red as the accent color, we was rocking with red. So I went with the Raging Bulls, the Bulls over Broadway 10s. And I didn't realize I hadn't worn these since SneakerCon.
Yeah,
so that's crazy. I hadn't had these on feet, so that's a little odd, but that's my pick for the day. Kadillac Jackson.
Yes, sir.
What did you have on feet today, bro?
I went with the Must Be the Monies. Must be the money that's got me looking cold. Mm. Must be the money, the jewelry and the goat must be the money.
I was watching something the other day, and they were singing Eddie Murphy's My Girl Likes to Party All the Time. And it had me thinking, when you hit that song, whose album was worse? Dion's or Eddie Murphy's?
Dion or Eddie Murphy?
I got to say Dion.
I got to say Eddie, because Dion was getting, he was getting play on MTV. They invited him to the summer house.
But just because he was getting paid doesn't mean it was better.
I didn't say it wasn't trash. Hold on.
It just wasn't garbage.
Exactly. But when that song came on, everybody was doing that Must Be the Money dance. Like, Must Be the Money.
But Eddie, bro. But Eddie, that shit came on. That video, I was like, no, brother, no. My little likes to party all the time. I was like, bro, who let him do this? Whose man's is this?
He was going for that other lane, so y'all, we just didn't understand, you know.
You might be right about that, brother. Hey, you know, he did on the album cover, he did have on a suit jacket with a bow tie and no shirt.
GN hit it right there. Look, what is that? He said Eddie Murphy had Rick James with him.
Stop it, GM. What we're not gonna do is disrespect the legends today. That's what we're not gonna do,
brother. Darkness,
that's not what we're gonna do today. That's not what we're gonna do. That's not what we're gonna do. Panky, Foam, Hump Day Heat. That's what 804 King of Foams and J's had on. I missed some other ones here. UnDS, the 110 IE, red and white joints. That's what's up, Jermaine Manning. I saw some other ones here. I'm scrolling back because y'all chatting today, and I love it. I love it. Who else did I miss?
DT had on the Lettermans.
Michael Jenkins had on the Toro 18s.
Oh.
KB Fresh Kick, Busted Old Work, Shocks. Yeah, whatever, dog. We're not hearing you. See, you disrespected this show far too many times for me to let that even be admitted. Burn Rubber Apollos, Young Reebok Questions. That's what's going on, Sports Guy Q. And that's it. That's it. Keep it rolling. Keep Field Boots. Come on, my shoe game. That's another one he could probably say whatever he wanted to, and I let that ride. My shoe game tight hand on the field boots. The dad kick, LeBron 12 lows. Is LeBron 12 low a dad kick already?
Wow. Okay. Yes.
It's a Burlington special, but is it a dad kick?
Why do you say it's a dad kick, bro?
I don't know. DreDay just be talking shit sometimes. It's a dad kick for him.
No, Kadi said yes. I'm trying to understand why.
The twelve low.
Mm-hmm.
12 low is a little daddish.
Wow. the swag came off it already.
Okay. Yeah, a little. Gonna go pick up the kids from soccer practice. Be right back. We're going to Cold Stone.
Yeah. Right. Michael Jenkins said, no, it's not. He said, no, it is not.
Sorry.
Always got, movie quotes on deck.
When you got little Volkswagen and little Chevrolet in the backseat, you'll be saying that. We're going to Cold Stone.
Who the fuck is fitting in the Volkswagen?
No. If you're Cadillac, your children are little Chevrolet and little Volkswagen.
It would be Porsche and Alexis.
Okay, all right. Little Porsche and Alexis. That's fine. Okay, if you want to do that, we can do that.
I want to let you know right now that if you name any of those kids Porsche and Alexis, I am renouncing my uncle rights. I am renouncing the throne. I will not have it. I will not have it. No. So we've stalled long enough. OG with his hump day heat and one of his pickups for the week. Go ahead, OG. Go ahead.
What's this, y'all? What's that right
Go
there?
Go ahead, OG.
What's that right there? What's that? Is that a W? That's an old wrinkled delayed W. It happened. My girl likes to party all the time. Party all the time. Party all the time. My girl likes to party all the time. Party all the time. I'm not taking off my shirt. I'm not
gonna. Whoa.
Hey, yo.
You said he was on it.
Man,
come on.
The shoes got a feeling right.
Got a red shoe, and he just like, oh yeah, this is my aphrodisiac. Like, what do you?
Toro 18s for everybody coming home from a side chick. Finally, came through. Sir. And I did something I never do because I got challenged, which was straight to the foot game. Shout out to Jumpman Bostic. They came last night, and I wore them today for Hump Day Heat. So love them. They're fire. Short little video coming probably later this evening. And, yeah, I'm glad I got them.
That's OG, them shoes are called the Bad Bitch 18s. Those are the Bad Bitch 18s right there, boy. OG had them on. QdaQueen said OG got the bangers.
Yeah. So, justice delayed but not denied.
Now, is that your only pickup for the week as well? Folks, we're rolling right into the pickup, so please roll. Post up your pickups if you want us to shout them out.
Pickups. I did that shadow thing.
Oh, okay. The Thot ones on deck.
Yeah, so I like them. I like them a lot.
Groupie ones.
Okay, that's what I think. Okay, whatever you say. But yeah, I'm good. That was it.
That's your two pickups.
That's it.
I also went ahead. You know, I went before OG, and I also hit up that thing too. I went ahead and hollered at real quick. I had to go ahead. Hey, QdaQueen, you got to wipe that down. You know what I'm saying? I went ahead and hollered at the chicken.
Yeah. Wait, you went before me. So that means I was second? Really?
Well, you know, if you wasn't first, you was last.
No.
If you wasn't first, you was last.
Hey, yo, what kind of show is this?
So I got the
totally different.
Look, that's what happens when he got kicked out of the pulpit. He like, hey, you know, I ain't got no church no more. I can just let it rip.
I'm a backslider now, so it is what it is, right? I'm out here in the streets with y'all at the club on Saturday night and in the church on Sunday. I got them Thot ones on deck and also came back from my crown real heavy. And this is going to be a PSA as well before we get to Kadi, who did some disrespectful shit last week.
I don't know what you speak of. Get in them crevices.
Got to get in them crevices, man. You got to make sure you get in them crevices. Before we let Kadi go, I went ahead and I felt disrespected, so I had to go back for my throne, and I got the Letterman ones.
Ooh.
Got these for $65 shipped.
Ooh, them St. Louis Cardinals.
Man, you know what I'm saying? And I will say this, you know, they're fairly clean. However, and I'm thankful for people who sell and trade used shoes. I really do appreciate that. But if you're going to sell or trade used shoes, if you smoke inside the shoe, or if you let your dog sleep in the shoe, put that in the ad. Just put that in the listing. That's all I'm saying. I know when listing, you're not a fan, but just you gotta. When I opened the box, I got high, and it was nothing in the box but the shoes. I said, "Oh my god!" And then I looked.
Oh my god!
The whole insole. Now you know the insole on this shoe is normally blue. I had to switch them out because it was full of dog hair. It looked like I had on a fur insole. I said, what the fuck did he do in these shoes? Of course, I didn't leave him no feedback because I was like, bruh, this is very disrespectful. But for the deal, I went ahead and went to work and I cleaned them. Thank you, Odor Control Spray. Non-sponsored. I went to work. I used about a whole can of them bad boys. But that was it. That was my pickles for the week. Keep it light. Hopefully, I get the congregation to come back to me. What kicks we got in the chat? What we got in the chat? What we got in the chat?
Jermaine Manning 06 got the double up shorty on the shadows. And the PG2 Mamba mentalities and the Wool 3s. Where does that sound familiar? Anyway.
Buckeye City sold. Now, here's the other thing, Buckeye. Good thing you called it out. He said, $65. You lucky you got laces. That's very true. How about the laces were tied in a knot on the ends right at the fucking eyelet? So I had to cut the laces out and use another pair of navy laces that I had. Couldn't even use laces. So you're right about that.
Oh, that's to get that. That's to get that good look with a shoe. Don't. Yeah.
I mean, he tied it right to knot, so it wasn't even enough room for me to pull the goddamn knot out. I said I just had to cut them. They had to go.
KB Fresh Kicks popped, copped the shadows and the Carmine Sixes.
Oh, that's what's up. That's a the Carmine Sixes. What's the price of the Carmine Sixes? If you don't mind telling us, tell us.
So he got the oop from Mo, aka Unbox App.
Hey, that's what's up. That's good shit, Mo.
Done.
Man, we got three.
Got the shadows and the Toro 18s.
Everybody got enough shadows, bro. Everybody took a turn, bro. Mm-hmm. That's not this week. So much for limited. Everybody got a turn on that. Props out to the Monday midsole who's rocking with us heavy this week. One Leg Lister, Buckeye City Soul is in here. Peace to Molly Mall, Polos and Jays, Mo, the Unbox App in the building. Rock with them on Mondays. Y'all know how they do. We appreciate y'all for fucking with us.
Yep. Yeah.
KB Fresh, he said 150. 150? Well, don't come back to the show. Don't come back to the show until you learn how to act. You don't know how to act. Oh, one late listener. We're not reading your pickups this week. You have been on a tear, my friend. No. Look at his
what?
List.
I'm not reading that. I'm not reading that.
Oh, no. No,
I'm not reading that.
No, I'm sorry.
He's matter going fact, down his list.
If I could get to my computer fast enough, I would delete that comment. hate.
We'll use our little bit of traffic that's in here. If you want to know what One Leg Lister picked up this week, go to his Instagram and look at the heat that he posted. The shit was disrespectful.
Don't go to his Instagram.
I mean, that shit was. He put up a list. He said, "This is my retirement list," and exactly. Apparently, people said they want him to retire.
Sports guy Q, exactly. Lister robbed the sneaker store.
Wow. So now we know what happened with Sneaker PMD. Now we know what happened. You put him out of business. Okay. That's what's up. So I'm stalling, right? I'm stalling. Cadillac Jackson.
Yes.
Go ahead and disrespect the whole damn show.
Well, I don't have much.
You lying son of a bitch.
The first thing I got was the other Laney. And yeah, I saw that on Instagram because I wore
straight to the feet.
Yeah, pretty much. The second thing I got.
What's up, DJ Martin?
Yay. Oh, yeah. Yay.
I didn't know you got those, bro.
Oh, yeah. Yes. I finally got my Shaka Zulu Air Force Ones. They have finally come in. Let our powers combine.
Even though I am clean. Not on board with the shoe that you buy, it is a very nice shoe.
I know, and I see clean. You looking.
It is clean.
Yes, the Black History Month Air Force One, and I can't wait to rock these. I need the nice shirt to go with them. But these will be on foot very soon.
Yeah, them clean, bro. Do you want to tell the people the price? Do you want to tell the people the price?
I got them for $120 before taxes, Chia Pet.
Mm. Chia Pet. It's a clean kick, and now... And now for the disrespect.
And now for I was trying to get a shoe and I had hit up a friend to
see whatever. Don could, Turner, what's up, bro?
To see if they could get it for me, but I had put in a bid on StockX and I put in a low bid. Mm-hmm. low bid hit.
Uh-huh.
And
whatever. What's up, black ass African?
Yeah. So. Oh. Yeah. Hello. Hey, what's up, baby? No. I'm just sitting here chilling with the fellas. You know, just showing off the shoe. Yeah, OG. I don't know what happened to OG, but yeah, his black ass will be back. And but yeah, baby, I'm gonna give you a call back. You know, we're doing a show right now. All right, love you, love you.
For the people that are still in the car driving from their side chick house, what do you have in hand, sir?
I have the LeBron Diez y Cinco, or as we call it in New York, 15. Orange box,
bro. The disrespect that just came across my phone.
You got to start blocking Lister during the show.
Look at this. This.
Why are you looking?
Wait.
Why
you got to start blocking Lister during the show?
Look at this, y'all.
I told you. And look. Lister said, "Hey, go read it. Fine. You gonna show it?"
Stop.
And he went. Oh. So Lister. So the one shoe I had that you didn't have that you wanted. You went and got the flints? Can't have shit. I can't have shit.
We can't.
We ain't got the flints. What's going on, Warrior Blood? He said he didn't get the notification. But that's what's up, man. Thank you for coming through.
Absolutely.
Kyler Park 81's in the building. What's going on, family? Yeah, Kadi just shut the show down, so it's been real.
I didn't shut the show down. I'm mad Don Turner said Kadi can go to hell. Damn.
I thought
Beard could go to hell. He's the unofficial pastor.
Cheers to Don Turner. He could definitely go to hell, sir. Yes. I'll drink to that. So, Kadi, can we please get off the pickups? I don't care. And One Leg Lister have showed your natural ass this week, and I don't appreciate it, and I don't respect it. Okay? All right.
I know not what you speak of, but okay.
No, I don't appreciate it, nor do I respect it. Do you have the releases for this week?
I sure do.
Let's talk about some more shit that I'm not buying.
And while he's pulling those up, please do us a favor and like the video.
If you like the video,
do that. Yeah. If you like the video, like the video. If you don't like the video, it'd be better.
Just let us know what we need to do to improve our scores.
All right.
What the hell is that?
Ladies and gentlemen, up first, coming out tomorrow, it is the Nike Air Max TN before and after the bite.
Wait, is that the actual name?
Yes, the gray ones are before the bite, and the red ones are after the bite, which is supposed to represent a shark's bite.
Really?
Yes.
Somebody does need to get fired.
These are actually two pairs of sneakers, not one in one.
Okay. Oh, so they're trying to get us to get the old pack. And the thing that you want me to have on is the fucking shark, the Jaws ones. That's what you're trying to sell me?
Yes.
So like I said, shoes that I'm not going to buy, that is a hell no. I'm not buying those. Man, DreDay Kicks and get that shit off the screen.
Next.
Up next from the Champions Think 16 pack, the Converse Pro Leather, the Scoop.
OG's gonna get how many pair? Three or four?
Yeah, you done know.
OG about to be sitting out here with a big old Afro wig on, listening to Stevie Wonder. I'm like,
yep, got it all day long.
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
It's a good looking shoe. It's a good looking shoe. I'm gonna pass, but it's a good looking shoe.
Yes. I don't know why they felt like they had to put those aglets or whatever on the toe, but yeah, I take that off. But yes, gotta have them.
The talented Mister said they trash.
Gotta have them anyway.
One lady listed said they look like boxing boots.
That's okay.
Y'all right. Turner said, "Where's the skate wheels for these Converse?"
Yeah. Okay, y'all. You can make all the jokes you want to make. It doesn't matter. I'm going to get it. It's from my childhood.
I can't even front. You look at them, you do think.
That's before that. You got to go back further, but I feel you.
It's all good. They dope. Kadi, you going to pick those up?
Pop. That's right. Just me and Pop. We going to get them all. So y'all just leave them alone. Y'all don't want them. Just leave them for me and Pop.
And if I get them, I'll probably get them for my brother.
You should. That would be dope. That would be a dope Christmas present, yo.
I think it's a clean ass.
But they're going to be sold out because you're going to buy all the pairs.
Well, you're right. So you might want to holler at me. I think I'll look out for you.
Yeah, I agree with you, QdaQueen. I think that's
dope. The
jokes are funny, but I do think that dope.
Up next.
What's the price point on those, by the way?
I don't know. Doesn't matter.
I know that you copied 17 pair. I just wanted to ask because
I got to get at least two.
Okay. Price point. Hold on. Tell you.
I got it. Second. Go ahead. Keep going. I got it. I'm opening the sneakers app now.
Okay. What's next on the list, Kadi?
100 beans. So you know I'm getting two of those.
Oh, that's not bad at all. That's not a bad shoe for $100.
Up next, the Rust Pink or Elemental Rose. Foam posits.
Warrior Blood so disrespectful. He said $25. Come on, man. Listen, come on, bro. 15 cent, really? That's all good. Don't matter.
The foams. Fake copper foams.
No. The faded copper.
I have to see these in person.
Oh, yeah. Here you go. No, you don't.
Yeah, I got to see these in person.
No, you don't. I'm telling you, you don't. You think you do, but you don't.
I think those are dope. I mean, I'm not gonna cop those. If I'm gonna get foams, those are not gonna be the first ones. But those look pretty straight. It's a different.
It's like 3 a.m. in the bar, bro.
Kadi, wait a minute. Those are kind of the color of the Hollywood 15s.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you're gonna have to buy double the shirts to match those shoes.
No.
DreDay Kick said, "I do not want to see them in person." Warriors Blood said it's the black bottom, maybe not these. 804 said he's not feeling these. And by the way, 804 has challenged the chat. If y'all are in here Friday, undie us a pair of kicks. Was it a pair of Jordans or was it just a pair of kicks? Let me know. 803 in the comment, 804 in the comments.
Listeners said he will point and laugh.
I mean, you know, Liz is feeling real good after that week he had. He caught all
the elite. I do agree. If it had a black bottom, it would be dope.
Well, if you watch 804 Keaton Foam and Jay's video, he can tell you how to paint them black.
Yeah, that's okay.
Damn.
Moving right along.
Yeah.
The Shadow 10s.
Yeah, that would be gray, right?
Yeah.
He doesn't do gray shoes, ladies and gentlemen.
Don't do gray shoes, man. I got the Thot 1s, but they haven't been worn. Oh. Just keep in mind, remember those wool threes that I bought last year? Those just got sold without me wearing them. I can't do the gray ones. I don't know, so we'll see. But no, these are passed for me. One Leg Lister got these.
You say, gotta get these. I'm not going to lie. The picture makes me want to get them.
Don't correct me, Kadi. One Leg Lister has those. Okay, yeah. Once he put it out there in the universe, he's got that shoe. That shoe's coming home.
So that shoe got a shipping tracking number already on it.
That like, shit is done, bro.
It's on the way. I don't know.
I feel I have like this love hate with 10s like I do with 5s. It's like I see the pictures and like dope, and then I get them and it's like wah. But so it's a pass for me probably. Somebody said they need them on sale. If they go on sale, yeah, maybe.
I don't know if these are going on sale.
I don't think they're going on sale. The hype is real for these.
Yes, they are OG, and that's probably if I do get them, Daniel, it will be because of that. That only.
Up next, Don
Turner said they're growing on him. Maybe if they go to the outlet down the line, Don Turner, the days of these new releases going to the outlet is over. It's not making the outlet, son.
Pretty much. Up next, go ahead. The Kyrie 4 White Deep Royal.
I'm going to disrespect the shoe right now and say 804 Kings of Foam and Jays said any shoe, UNDS, any shoe on Friday. That's what the fellas want you to do for Saturday Night Live. I definitely talk about something else because this shoe is
trash.
Trash to me, bro. Get on that.
Yeah, this shoe is I'm good.
They've been way off with the colorways. The shoe is dope. It's a very comfortable shoe, but they just, man, there's been so many misses on the colorways. And usually, you know, they by now they would have had some dope colorways. I don't know what it is. I think when he went to Boston, I think that just messed up their whole rotation that they had planned or something, because it just, man, it's whack.
Hey, I'm with my homie Jermaine Manning on that. I'm sleep on these. And one late listener says he has no DS shoes. Zero. He wears all the shoes in his collection. Respect to that, brother. Respect.
Okay. Well, that means you got to go buy something and then wear it.
Up next, the Nike Air Max 97 Patchworks in honor of Cristiano Ronaldo.
The more I see of these shoes, the doper they look. I'm going to pass, but it's a good-looking shoe.
I'm going after these shits.
That's a good-looking shoe.
Yeah, I'm good.
That's all you got. You ain't even interested in the patchwork, the different materials, none of that. You just
– so, you know, I've said this before. I'm red like, shoe. I just got that schizophrenia. Sometimes I see them like, I got to have it. And then other times I'm like, no. So I like the idea. Maybe if it was the different, you know, something else, maybe. But
that's definitely a good looking shoe.
What I really want is those Sean Weatherspoon LeBron 15s. Y'all saw that picture?
Good luck with that.
Yeah, I thought that was dope, man.
Yeah, these are definite for me. Need these. Up next,
DreDay kicks ass. Is that a woman's shoe? I think that is a men's shoe, sir.
That's a men's shoe. Up next, the LeBron Soldier 12 Dark 23.
If you don't get them Debo 15s up out of here, bro.
What is that?
Batman.
That boy looks like, it looks like you need to feed that shoe. Can you pet it? Nah, bro. That shit is terrible.
That is definitely a hooping shoe.
A hooping what? Hula hooping? That shit is ugly, bro. That shit is terrible, B.
Wow.
That was He said soldier hose, Ross Brown. What the fuck are those? Said 804 King of Foes and Jays. Man.
Mr. Fair 76 hit you with 3 poop emojis.
Those are hot garbage. What are those? Does anyone like them? I just want to hear, does anyone like this
particular Tristan team? Thompson likes them.
Maybe he'll go for another triple-double off the court. Yeah, not in those shoes, bro.
And that's all we got for the pickups.
Nice.
Yeah. Walmart-ass boots is what black-ass African said. LeBron K and G Soldier 12s. LeBron going 50 points tonight. Are they still winning, Q?
Winning by 7.
Right. Only 7. Come on, man. LeBron get you 20 points in the first quarter. Y'all got to help him out. Jesus Christ. Y'all got to help him out. One late listener said those are all right. Okay. All right.
The talented Mr. said those shoes get the donkey of the day.
I would agree with him. I would agree. There you go. My shoe game tight all day, all night. Like them, man. Rock what you like, brother. I can respect that. I don't like the shoe, but I can respect that you like, hey, I got them. Shit. That's dope. All right, man. Let's get into the show. This is what we do. Y'all know what time it is. It's time for the Lace Up.
Lace Up.
We got a couple topics that we didn't get to last week because Black Ass African was on the show.
The official pastor.
I gotta take this shit. I got to pick friends. I know that. I got to pick better friends. So over the week, past couple days, we heard about Starbucks. Two black men were chilling in Starbucks, waiting as what that's what people do in Starbucks, right? You just do stuff. You're reading books on the internet, conducting business, probably looking at people in yoga pants. I don't know what you do in Starbucks. I don't drink coffee like that. But they were in Starbucks chilling, and somebody called the cops, one of the workers of Starbucks. The cops came and arrested these two gentlemen. Then a couple days later, we saw another video of Starbucks where a brother asked to use the restroom and get the code because they got the locks on the doors. They went to use the restroom. They said he couldn't use the restroom because he did. It was for paying customers. Somebody came out of the restroom that was a white gentleman, and he had got the code and didn't buy anything yet. So now, coming full circle from that embarrassment, Starbucks owner Hollywood Schultz, or his CEO or some shit like that, said that he's ashamed and that they're going to shut down businesses for half a day so they can go through diversity training. I want to know what OG thinks about this whole breakdown. What is your feedback, sir?
God, we'll be here all night.
Well, you only got 6 minutes.
Totally not surprised, but disgusted. If I felt anything good about the video, I saw that it was a non-melanin person that was questioning the police in the video and saying, hey, they weren't doing anything. Why are they being arrested? Which gives me hope. Mm-hmm. I also, as a person that works in that particular area, to say that you're going to close all your stores for half a day to give your employees diversity training, while on his face may seem great, it's really a joke because they need more than a half a day. And even the people that don't think they need it because they need reinforcement about what not to do that they haven't been doing.
Okay.
I also think that, you know, whoever made the phone call needs to get fired. Because in addition to giving help, you also need to set an example that we're not going to tell you. We're not going to stand for this. There's no reason to do that. And yeah, I don't want to use up the whole 6 minutes.
That's what's up, Kadi. What are your thoughts, sir?
Looking at the whole situation, my main thing, there were a couple of moments where I said, I need answers. Number one, why wasn't anybody fired? If they've been fired, I haven't heard anything as of yet. But I was wondering, why weren't they fired? Why did there have to be an investigation? Number two, the cops on the video, why aren't they being investigated? Because you clearly see a guy saying, why they're just sitting here, they're not doing anything. Mm-hmm. And they were still arrested. And another woman says, I have it all on video. Nobody pulled that woman to the side and said, hey, let me look at this video for a second. If you have witnesses that say, hey, they didn't do anything, why are you still arresting them? I don't understand that.
And I think in the count, did you say, Kadi, it was like 7 police officers or something like that?
There's 7
guys.
7 police officers for 2 males.
And I understand, you know, I've trained in law enforcement. I worked in it for 12 years. I understand the safety and, you know, but everybody didn't need to come in the store. You know, if you're going to have that big of a response, everybody don't need to get out of the car and stand around in your biker shorts. It was just like, it was extra. And I do have one more comment, Beard. I don't want to cut you off.
I will say that I'm not trained in law enforcement. My father is a police officer. I know some police officers. I imagine if you get called to the scene and you're told someone is trespassing and they're asked to leave and they don't leave, maybe that's a procedure. I don't know. What I do know is that the reason that I think people are not asking what the cops did or why they're not worried about the cops is because that's what the fuck cops do. Cops show up and shoot or arrest black people. That's the fuck they do. That part, what they did, didn't surprise me. But that didn't surprise me at all. I'm not shocked by them. Why weren't they questioned? Because they did what they do. That's what the fuck happens. I'm happy they didn't beat their ass. I give you that. It's sad that I feel like I'm grateful that they didn't slap the shit out of them with the goddamn nightstick. I agree with what both of y'all said. The person that called the cops, they need to be fired, or you know, something needs to happen to them. And QdaQueen said that the manager ended up getting fired. So, and as far as the diversity training thing, half a day, I'll say this. I don't know how legit that is. I'd be wasting my time if I spent my time worrying about how legit actions like that are. I can appreciate the fact that they feel like we at least need to blow smoke up the country's ass and close down our stores for money, because you're going to lose money. Yes. You're going to close down your stores for half a day to make it look good. Hey, I don't know if I should say thank you, but I can appreciate that on a certain level for a certain reason. I don't know if it's going to change anything. And again, we're in another situation where people are boycotting Starbucks. They probably didn't go to Starbucks anyway. I don't go to Starbucks. So me saying I would boycott Starbucks is useless. Go ahead, OG.
The question that I had, actually, that dovetails into it perfectly. I saw a post where someone said that we should not boycott all Starbucks, but boycott the Starbucks in Philadelphia where the incident occurred, because that's painting with too broad of a brush. What do you guys think about that?
So there's another Starbucks two blocks away from that one, I'd imagine. In each direction, there's another Starbucks two blocks away. So they'll just diversify their funds. This is kind of like if nobody goes to the other sports games and the NCAA men's football team is still playing, that sport is still going to be there because it still gets some of that money. Mm-hmm. So you cannot show up there and they're still going to get money and they'll still be running. This is kind of how stores work. You have an off day. I've worked in a store that didn't make the day ever. That never made the day in like 3-4 months, but the other stores around did, so we just were able to float. That's what's gonna happen. I get the point. I get the premise. My only response would be, instead of all this boycott, support the motherfuckers that take care of your community in the first place, and you don't have to worry about boycott. Mm-hmm. What about you, Kadi?
I agree with everything you said. Like I was just looking at the statement that the commissioner had gave in an interview.
Yeah, Don Turner asked about that. I wasn't
familiar. Yeah, and he said that, you know, the officers really didn't want to make the arrest. And it was like, so why did you? That's what.
Wait, I'm not. He said, what?
He said the officers didn't really want to make the arrest.
Right. Okay.
And I'm like, you don't have to. So why did you?
Exactly.
And it's like, look at everything that has gone on in the past, let's say 2 years. And here you are in a situation where you see two black men sitting in a coffee shop, not doing anything, just sitting there.
No, Don Turner said, no, that's not what he said. I believe when I heard the audio, he said that he agrees with them. They didn't do anything wrong. They follow procedure.
From the article, let me see, ABC6. Let me see.
The talented Mr. said, we gotta stop hitting them in the pockets, companies like that. Don Turner says that the officer said he did their jobs. Yeah.
Well, if you want to call that doing their jobs because they made an arrest, okay, but come on. We got to start looking at common sense.
So that goes back to what I said when I started, though. If the call they got is from the manager or somebody who's superior in that chain and they said that these people are trespassing, they need to fucking leave, and officers got there and said, we need you to leave or we'll make you leave. Their job as a civil servant is to take these people off the property.
But here's,
I'm not defending them, but I'm saying this. If no, that's their job,
I get what you're saying, but here's my question. How is it that this is still happening? How is it that police are not using more common sense? This has been happening over and over and over and over again.
You're confusing common sense of the people with common sense of the law. The law is not made to protect our ass. It was not set up to protect our ass. It was set up on the backs of our asses. So the officers did what they're supposed to do, eliminate the black ass threat. That's what they do. Sometimes it takes a bullet. Sometimes it takes the cuffs, but that's what they do. That's what they're constructed to do.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. First off, people should have a safe place to meet up with others. Starbucks is a very common meeting spot. Absolutely. Exactly.
Absolutely. It gets tiring in this country that we still see melanin as a weapon. You know what I mean? Oftentimes, if you're black, that's enough of a weapon for them to decide that, you know, you're threatening. You're black and you were running, so I had to shoot you. You're black and you held up a pipe, so I had to shoot you. You're black and you wouldn't just get down on all fours and lay face down in the dirt, so I had to shoot you. Often melanin is treated like a weapon, and this is no different. I'm not defending the cops. What I'm saying is that they followed the letter of the law, if that's the story, because the law is set up on some bullshit. That's the kind of stuff that needs to change. Now, here's a story that I don't know a whole lot about. I'm going to be serious about this bullshit. I don't know a lot about this, but I'm going to go ahead and put it up there. I think that you fellas know more about this than I do. Nike is going through some shit. Nike's going through some shit. They were supposed to be going through some executive training and looking at what was going on with the Me Too movement is the best way I can put it together. Y'all know what's supposed to happen. And people is leaving and getting fired. OG, please put us up on game with the Nike execs leaving, because I heard another exec left today.
Oh, wow. I was so busy at work today. I didn't really see much of the news. But, I mean, I was the one that brought this story up. And to me, you know, I mean, you all know my thing about the Black history, and I don't have to rehash that. But just in terms of, like, for a company that, you know, one of their biggest kind of things that they report and put out there, you know, is this equality thing, and to, you know, be trying to brand your company and your products and sell it through that, but you don't have equality going on inside of your own walls, is just like the height of hypocrisy. So, you know, the first things that came to light were some executives that had been dismissed based on some questionable activity that, you know, would come under scrutiny in the Me Too situation. However, other executives since then have come out and said not only do they have issues in terms of hiring executives at female executives, but also minorities. So, you know, it's basically, you know, the all white boys club, you know, at a certain rank within the organization, which is completely contrary to, you know, the thought of, you know, equal opportunity for all. And so it's just kind of sad. I mean, not that we sit out here and root for people to fall, but it's really almost, you know, that Malcolm X chickens coming home to roost, you know, situation when you think about it. And it was just intriguing to me that, you know, is wow, you would think that if that was something that was really important to you in the core, that would be important through your organization, but, you know, clearly it's more words than it is deeds.
I feel like maybe in business in this country, when you get to a certain size, I guess I can't see even in this country, across the world, you get to a certain size and it's hard for you to back up and fix stuff. And I feel like culturally for us, we tend to fix without apologizing. And that doesn't necessarily fix shit. Just removing people sometimes isn't always the way to fix something. You have to fix it systemically. You have to make the change. Starbucks, like we said in the previous segment, even though they're doing, they're closing the business for half a day, they also announced a new lead of relations or something, which was a black female. They are trying to do, or at least make it look like they're doing, you know, intentions, we'll never know, but they're trying to make it look like they're fixing shit. If you're in a situation with Nike and you're marred in a business and an industry, which is patriarchal and sexist and bent on exposing weakness, you know what I'm saying? You got people working in sweatshops, and we've heard all the stories about Nike. Instead of just saying, okay, I'm out, acknowledge the shit that you did wrong and then try and fix it. You don't just get to leave. You don't just get to fucking leave. And so if you're like, okay, we're not doing a good job of hiring minorities, we're not doing a good job of hiring women, let's fix that. All right, I'm out. I done did some shit that don't work. I'm out. No, acknowledge that you did some fucked up shit and fix it. I don't like these people just getting the dip like that. That's all. That's the only thing I got from it. You know, it's Nike, you're on the front lines of this. Fix it. Cool. Hopefully everybody else is going to follow suit and fix it. That's all I got.
You know, the crazy part about all of this is the fact that they tell you to leave. Like, for example, Trevor Edwards. He left. He's retiring in August, but he goes home with a pension and severance pay. Wow. He's going home with over $500,000. So, is he really losing?
I mean, if he wants to work again, he is.
If he wants to work again, he is. But at 55 years old, you've been with the company for, I don't know if it was 12 years. Might have been less than that. It might have been less than that. But it's like there are no real repercussions other than we're going to give you a chance to walk away. And yeah, it's like you've held back all these people's careers. You've done things to them in the workplace. You know that in some place, in some aspects, is irreversible.
Right. Right.
So there's people that you got to look at this like there's people that are stuck in their positions because you did certain things. There are women who are stuck in certain positions where they should have moved up years ago, who now, you know, there's a possibility they may never move up because you held them back because you have no real reason why. And that's hurtful. That it's hurtful and it's disrespectful that, as OG put it, for you to push equality but not use equality in your workplace.
That's real shit. That's real shit. Going back to OG's initial statement about the equality pact, like there's a lot of inconsistencies with the company, as are with a lot of companies. And when yours is on Front Street like Nike's is, you're starting to look real funny across the board. You patronize. Like, this is, I guess, the best example I can use, not that you necessarily need an example, but I'm kind of talking this out, is wrestling. WWE is a sexist, racist wrestling. Let's not even say WWE. Wrestling is a racist, sexist entertainment industry. And every February, we get the Black History Month shit, and they talk about the same black wrestlers every time they walk them out there. And then when it's time to talk about women, or we talking about breast cancer, we end up talking about women. We do the same shit every year. And then you go back and watch, and you look at WWE's history, and you're like, for the big wrestling title, The Rock was the last black or partially black champion. If you go before The Rock, you going back to shit. There's like, we're talking about The Rock back in the early 2000s. Since then, y'all ain't had another one that could get the big title. What about Mark Henry? Mark Henry got the secondary world title. He didn't get the big one. We talk about black champion. We're talking about Naomi. None of the other black women, Naomi and then Jacqueline, which is from the 90s. Like, it's for you to talk about progress and shit, let's not forget that you had a team of Mexicans that came out on the fucking lawnmower. But every year you trumpet this thing about equality and how you're doing great for the business. Like, no, you're not. We can see you. And how much of that shit are we going to put up with? At the end of the day, this shit about Nike and equality, we still going to end up buying some more goddamn Nike shoes. And I don't know what the fix is. It's this kind of shit is like, what do you do to fix it? We can boycott Starbucks, but are we going to fucking boycott? Are we going to boycott Nike? Should we boycott Nike? I don't know what the fix is. Booker T, I'm looking at the chat now. Sasha Banks, good thing. What I was saying about Naomi, Naomi was the last one to win at WrestleMania. Big pay-per-view. Booker T. Booker T came in with the WCW title. He didn't come in and win the big WWF title. He lost to Triple H. Booker T didn't hold that belt. So it's shit like that. I don't know what the fix is, but my question, and this is, you know, we've already gone over time. This is a question for OG because I'm going to go to the big brother on here. I'm going to respect my elders and ask, is there a point and should there be a point where we get tired of just boycotting?
Not without a plan. I mean, I think that situations are evolving, and I think, you know, and, you know, Sis, you know, Q could probably speak to this, you know, maybe a little bit more better than I can. But, you know, in terms of in activism, we're in a time right now where we need to, or it's being suggested, I don't want to say it definitively, but it's suggested that we need to change our tactics. That some of the things that worked at a certain time are not things that are appropriate or effective in this season. And, you know, everything changes and becomes different and we have to change our tactic with it. So I'm not sure to stop and answer your question. I don't think that we need to stop that until we have something that is equally or great, more effective. And I don't think that we've found what that thing is yet.
It's an interesting concept. You know, we're all in this idea. Everybody wants to make an omelet. Nobody wants to break eggs. And I'm not saying that, you know, that you need to bust some heads, but I'm saying sometimes some heads need to be busted to make some shit change. That's all I'm saying. I mean, there's only so much marching and voting you can do. I'm not trying to incite a riot. I'm just saying, and sometimes you got to get tired of marching and voting. I would imagine.
Yeah.
I would imagine.
Well, that's what, I mean, like I said, I think it that we need a solution, you know, or some different tactics. And, you know, and sometimes you don't know that the solution is the solution until you try and you see that, you know, it has affected, you know, the end. But, yeah, I mean, stop boycotting and vote. I mean, that really takes us back to the beginning from the standpoint of, you know, being able to exercise the voice that, you know, people fought and died to get. And you know, that may be one of the, if not the most effective tool. You know, there's a whole other discussion that you can have about that in terms of people seating themselves inside of organizations that they normally would not be part of to be able to gain control of those organizations.
DreDay Kick said they would bust more of our heads than we could do damage to them. Sometimes it's not about obliterating the opposition. Sometimes you just got to weaken them motherfuckers a certain way so you can get the W. That's all I'm saying. That's all. That would be a whole nother discussion for getting that through. The employees are boycotting by quitting, perhaps. That's what QdaQueen said. In my opinion, I think Nike, the issues lie within the organization towards employees. They have not positioned anything towards the consumer for us to feel the need to boycott. Voting doesn't work unless everybody of all races votes. If voting worked, it would be illegal. DreDay Kick said, how? Okay. I don't know. I don't know. I have no ideas. I'm just putting it out there for discussion. And I know OG is a strong proponent of voting. A lot of people are. I'm not saying that that's the wrong answer. Not at all. that's just be it'd be another discussion for a whole another day.
No doubt.
But I just think it's interesting to see how people are still discussing what's supposed to happen to make things change. And we're not holding the people fully responsible. You know, everybody wants to talk about the boy that was hugging the cop, but they don't want to talk about the family that killed that boy. You know what I'm saying? If y'all don't know about that story, when they had the riots in Ferguson, there was a picture that went viral of a boy hugging the cop. Come to find out, he was an adopted kid to a white couple, and they ended up abusing the kids, and they drove the kids and themselves off of a cliff. A
cliff in California. Yep.
So if we're talking about systemic, we're talking about the system that allowed them to be adopted by an abusive couple that allowed them to continue to abuse those kids. And we're still talking about this fucking picture. Fuck that picture. All right. Fuck that picture. I'm not going to go too far off on that. Let's get into some shoes, man. I know the chat is popping. They already watching the game. Let's get into the shoe discussion here. Let's talk about some more scandal, but we're going to talk about shoes. There was a little place that we all know of that Kadi is very familiar with because he knows all the sneaker plugs. It was called Supplied PDX. Allegedly Supplied PDX, and the owner of Supplied PDX got busted for selling millions of fake sneakers.
And millions.
Kadillac Jackson, what percentage of your collection came from Supplied PDX?
Not a damn thing.
What do you think about this shit? If you want to give the people the short story or the long story, if you want to.
You know what? Supplied PDX. There were still people who were buying Supplied PDX, even after they found out they were selling fakes. Thinking like, well, maybe it's just one or two pairs. Maybe, you know, maybe they're just, I don't know. There's got to be one real one in there. Like, people were buying the Concords and everything. And the thing is, when being that you, if you've bought from Supply PDX, what do you do now? What do you do? Well,
I mean, I don't know that any of these people.
You make a video that says, I'm selling my sneaker collection.
We're not saying that's what happened. Yeah.
I'm sorry. We're not saying that's what happened,
but I'm saying that was interesting.
I'm not saying that's what happened, but I'm saying that's what happened.
I have no insights on where anybody got their collection. I'm just saying that. This happened, and a lot of people sold sneakers. And this just, like, for me, I don't know about for y'all, but for me, this takes me out of the early game. Not that there's not people who are selling earlies that are legit. I just don't want to risk it because I personally am not a fan of having fakes in my collection when I think I'm buying the real shit. So I personally don't like fakes, but at the same time, I'm not the person that's going to buy fakes if I think I'm buying the real shit, especially. So for me, I'm out the game, bro. I'm not doing the earlies. If it's not coming from a big box or the source, I'm good on the early joints. I'm good.
What about if it comes from StockX?
I haven't bought from StockX yet, and I don't know that I would buy from StockX, to be completely honest. I don't know. To me, that bothers me, the idea of rocking some fakes. Like, you know, there's shoes that I've had that I was like, I don't know that these are legit.
Yeah, I haven't worn them because I don't know.
Yeah, I'm looking, you know, I'm doing all the research and shit. I just don't know. So for me, it makes more sense for me to know that I got some legit shoes on my feet, even if they got quality issues, than to have a pair of fares and I think that they're a pair of fakes and I think that they're legit. So for me, that takes me out the game. What about you, OG?
I just wanted to answer one question. Somebody, maybe it was Warrior Blood, asked, what is supply? It's actually Supplied. SUPPLIED. PDX was the company. Right.
Yeah.
And I was just trying to actually pull up some information.
Yeah, about 6 years ago, they were like, Supplied PDX was one of those sites where they always posted shoes on Instagram and dope pictures and like almost like a mixture of an influencer, and we get shoes early and we have the exclusives, and you would go there, you know, you go to their site and you go look at their shoes, like, oh, they got Concords and they're not too expensive, but and then, you know, you look at it, you get ready to go buy it, and then you read in their comments on their Instagram, hey, it's been 2 months and I haven't gotten my shoes yet. I didn't even get a tracking number. Nobody's responded to my emails. And you're like, yep, I'm going to just sit here with this money in my pocket and let it burn hole in.
Yeah. So according to reports, Nike was working with federal authorities for nearly all of 2015. And he would, the former owner, I won't bother giving his name, was arrested and was believed sold, as we said, over millions of dollars worth of fake shoes. And he ended up having to pay like $100,000 to Nike and an additional $50,000 to cover the brand's legal costs for trying to bring him to justice for selling fake shoes.
It's rough, man. I mean, this is what happened. And the thing that aggravated me about it was that he was trying to say that he was trying to take care of his customers. So he got into the game legit. The way the story goes is he got into the game legit. He was able to secure rare pairs of shoes and exclusives and then sell them to his people. And the demand became stronger, so then he started doing fakes. That's some bullshit. Like, again, this is what I was talking about earlier when I said sometimes to fix shit, you need to show contrition and then fix it. You don't get just – he just kept on selling fakes. Like, you just kept on selling $1 million worth of fake shoes? Come on, bro. You're not helping your customers by selling them bullshit. You say, hey, I ain't got them. I ain't got them, bro. Sorry, you lose the business, but you're not selling fakes. You fucking up the game that you allegedly love. And that's whack, man. That's whack. I can't rock with that shit. So I'm out on that. Where we at? 837, cool. So we still got a little bit more time here. Let's get into OG's favorite pack. Based on the shoe that we saw coming out, the Think 16 pack is coming out. We got a lot of retros in here. We got to see that Dr. J, which is part of the pack. If I'm looking at this, these are going to be the 15 confirmed releases. If I'm looking at this list right, Kadi, you have to let me know if I'm right or wrong on this.
Okay.
The Kobe Bryant Proto 1's Final Seconds, a.k.a. the Closeouts.
Yes.
The Dr. J Converse Pro Leather Mid, a.k.a. the Scoops.
Yes.
The Rasheed Wallace Nike Air Force 1 High Rude Awakening.
That is but don't lie! Name. Yes.
That's a dope-ass name. The Kawhi Leonard Air Jordan 1 High Pass the Torch. Yes, that's the one with the silver that we saw. Yeah. The Bill Russell Converse Chuck Taylor Ox 30 and 40.
Ooh, that's gonna be a foot herder. OG got it up on his screen. OG, lock yourself in.
Oh, okay. If this is a book that I got, this is like one of their promotional books, like some of the stuff that Black was talking about. He used to get ordered back in the day, but it has every one of the shoes in there, of course. Yeah, y'all know that. That's got to be the one. Scoop. That Rasheed Wallace.
Oh, don't lie.
Sorry. It's kind of. This is not a great picture because some of these are artwork. But
so that's the Kawhi Leonard, right?
Yeah, that's Kawhi Leonard. And that, of course, the hits where you see are silver. They're like that really metallic-y, kind of almost like the mirror. Type
form. But so that silver looks like plastic.
Yeah. And then the next one probably on your list should be that
Scottie Pippen Nike
Air Maestro.
Yeah, they're calling it the trifecta.
I think that Buckeye City Soul has a pair of those, if I remember right. I think he did a picture of those, and those are nice. Those are nice.
And then we have this. This is the. They're calling this Locked and Loaded, which is the
Ray Allen
PE.
The Air Jordan 28.
Yeah, with the shroud action. And
He had a Jordan drop, like, what was it, 6 pair of shoes with the uncircumcised look?
This is called No Easy Buckets, and it's a Kevin McHale.
I'm not even going to lie. Hold on. Let me see if I can bring it up on my screen so that we can get
a good look at it.
I think I have the same pictures you have.
Mm-hmm.
So I have it up on my screen now.
So you ain't got to keep turning the pages, OG. That's what Catlin said. You're fired.
Okay. Fire me.
He fired you just like they fired me last week. OG, it's going around. I can't wait till we fire Kadi.
OG, you're the elder. We would never fire you. I don't know who this other guy is.
So the next one, bitch. Intangibles, which is, I think that's the one for Wes Unsell. It's another Converse. Yeah. We don't have to go with him in the order. I got him. Just go for it.
Okay. So.
That's the intangibles, right?
Yeah, there. That's the intangibles. Yeah. The Maestros, the Scottie Pippen joints, Trifecta, Ray Allen's.
Nope.
Oh, don't lie. The Moses Malones.
Yes.
The 4-5 shots. Maya Moore's.
Maya LeBron Moore's.
James.
25 straight.
The Kobe's.
Final seconds.
Kevin McHale's. Thunder Buddies for Life, Kadi 4.
Battle Tested is the name.
The Kawhi Leonards.
And Pass the Torches.
The Scoops.
Yeah.
The Bill Russells. And the Air Force 70 Gold Standard.
Now, that's the only one that I was like, really? Why, y'all?
Now, why? Out of all these shoes.
Yes.
Which one is your favorite and which one is your least favorite?
Ooh. As much as I love 1's, I really dislike the Kawhi. I really dislike it. Like the shiny, that might be the one. I think for me, that's the one. The Kawhi Leonard is the one I dislike the most. And I'm a sucker for 1's. The one I like the most is probably that Kevin McHale.
I'm not going to lie to you. That Kevin McHale one is pretty clean. That fast break high?
Yeah. That Kevin McHale
clean as shit. See, if you know me, I'm old school. A Boston starter jacket with this?
Mm-hmm.
That most is clean, bro.
Mm.
What about you, OG?
That I like the most, I'm probably conflicted between.
We know the Dr. J's
and the LeBron.
Oh,
really? Okay.
Wasn't you the 25 straight?
Yes.
Interesting. What about the least favorite? And chat, y'all can chime in too. You know what I'm saying? Y'all part of the show.
I probably have to say their gold standard because I just don't think it belongs, and that's just a money grab. For them trying to throw in their new shoe into that collection, it shouldn't have been there. It's something else that could have been there that took the spot for.
I gotcha. Yeah. All right. So my favorite is actually a tie between two shoes. It's between Boy Don't Lie and the Trifecta, because the Trifecta to me is really the red Maestros that Scottie Pippen had on in the All-Star game.
Okay.
So those are my favorites.
Jay Manning said, we just disrespecting the last shots. Ain't nobody disrespecting the last shots. It's just, come on. You got to expand your horizons, bro. There's no disrespect.
My least favorite, and this is, I'm sorry, it's got to be the Maya Moore shoe.
You know what? Nike's been very disrespectful to Maya Moore the entire time they've had her. Like, she's way too talented for the bullshit they throw in her way.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, Maya Moore has had some crazy PEs. Crazy PEs. And y'all gave her a girlish PE. Like, oh, these are in honor of Maya Moore. No, it's not. Like,
you could have gave her one of the P's that she wore in the WNBA finals. Like, she had some dope PE. She wore Jordan 20, what was it, the 28 SE, the one without the shroud?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She wore that, and she had a PE color. And just give her this color, I feel like that was the easy way out. Like, we'll just give her that, and we'll put Maya Moore's logo on it and call it a day.
I'm going to go ahead and be totally disrespectful. Melo has a championship shoe coming out for the Jordan, and he won shit since college. Maya Moore has won 4 pro championships and 2 college championships, and that's what the fuck she got. That's disrespectful as fuck. Y'all deserve to give Maya Moore more than this shit, and if she left for Adidas, I wouldn't be mad. Y'all very disrespectful. She's a fucking 4-time WNBA champion, like 5-time All-Star, a 2-time All-Star MVP, 5-time first all-WNBA team, 2-time all-defensive WNBA team. And this is what y'all gonna do, bro? Come on, bro. That's very fucking disrespectful. But Melo has got a championship shoe coming out. Y'all had to reach all the way back to his college days to get the Melos. Fuck out of here, bro.
So DreDay Kick says the 270 is for the trophy, I thought. Yeah, it is for the trophy. My point was not that it was stupid to have the trophy. It just was it's not a basketball shoe. Mm-hmm. It's just their newest, you know, new kid on the block, and they're throwing it in the collection. And to me, it just doesn't make any sense. It's just, I'm not saying that something shouldn't be mirroring the trophy. I'm just saying it should have been another shoe. That's all.
Yeah, I think they were trying to blend the new with the old, and that one, they forced that one in. You could have done something else. You definitely could have done something else.
I think my issue with that 270, if that toe is gold, like the gold on the side, oh, that wrinkly is gonna look horrible.
I don't think it is. It looks like it's like a different type of material.
I don't know, bro.
It's hard to tell because it's kind of a more painting than an actual picture. It'll be interesting. I also want to know what the mystery shoe is.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a mystery shoe on that one too.
Okay. Yeah, because there is, if they have the picture here, there's a shoe.
Yeah, that's under the cover.
Yeah, under that cover at the top. I don't know what that shoe is.
Okay. It'd be interesting to see what that is. It's going to be a Jordan and what? That's how I feel. Like, it's going to be a Jordan. Which one is it?
Oh, Kadi, look in that picture. If you look at the 270s, it does look like it's the same material on the toe box.
That's going to look horrible when it creases.
Mm-hmm.
Lord Jesus.
Now, we haven't, we're not watching the playoffs now. So, Kadi, don't cheat. Chat, don't cheat. Don't let us know. We're going to do a little round robin kind of thing here, like a pool. We'll call this an NBA pool. So each week we're going to pick a team from the playoffs that we think is going to make it to the next round. The way that this is going to work is that you can't pick the same team twice. So we're taking today's standings. In other words, Kadi OG, if y'all think that the Golden State Warriors are going to be in the finals, you might not want to pick them this round, because the next round you have to pick another team. And the next round you have to pick another team. So pick a team, either East or West, that you think is going to make it to the next round. I'll start with the basketball savant, Kadillac Jackson. Yes, we know that some of these games have been played. What's the team that you're picking to make it to the first round that you can never pick again?
Ooh, this is
OG, you got the list on the screen. Lock yourself in,
so
please.
Bad. This is gonna be so bad.
Choose wisely, sir.
And I'm gonna have to go sneak A for this. All right. So I'm looking at the list that OG has up. And it seems Dwayne Wade Flash has come back.
Oh.
And I really like what he did last night. But can he carry the Miami Heat for another 3 more games? And here's the deal. And now this is going to be on the video. The Miami Heat will beat the Philadelphia 76ers. in seven games.
Wow, you might be going for the second round already, nigga. You might be going for the second round already. Is that your final answer, sir?
I really don't want to say.
You ain't got to pick them. That's what you said out your own mouth. That ain't goddamn 10 ain't games.
Locked in. There's no walking that one back.
Whew. The Heat is a team that you're picking to make it to the next round.
Whew. Let's lock it in.
Wow.
You got to write it down.
We playing with house money. Let's lock it in.
I don't think we're going to hear another pick from Kadi. It's about to be in for Kadi. The next pick we hear from him will be for charity. Let me write this down. Kadi? Heat. OG, who you got? What team can you pick that's not going to make it? You can't pick them again. So what team are you picking to make it to the second round and you're fine with not having another choice?
Raptors.
That was quick. OG, you been thinking about this?
They up 2-0.
Oh, he cheated. That's a cheat code. That's what happens when we do the show late. Picking the Raptors. That's a safe pick.
Beard Jedi.
Beard Jedi's on the clock. Matter of fact, I'm going to make it interesting because OG's he's secure. Can he pick the Heat? I'm picking the Sixers. One of us ain't getting the pick next time. One of us ain't picking. One of us will definitely be eliminated. I'm going with the Sixers, sir. We're going to speed this up. I'm going to go with the Sixers. I wanted to kind of go with the Pelicans, but I want to stay away from that. The Trailblazers in the playoffs is a different team. Ooh. AD's good, but you got 7 games to win, bro.
DG.
You got 7 games to win. But they're
picking the Bucks.
Mm-hmm. What's good, Chris Kicks Dubai in the building?
That's not a bad pick.
It's not a bad pick, but Eric Bledsoe's getting killed right now.
That motherfucker's getting filleted. Yeah, yeah,
tween, yeah. Tween, tween. Ain't nothing over there, bro.
What you looking for? Filleted. Some of y'all even have the pick. Can we get these down? So Don Turner said the Bucks.
We're gonna Black ass go African said the Pelicans.
Pelicans. Y'all don't win shit, by the way. This is just for bragging rights.
So are we doing each conference or are we just one team?
No, you just get one team per round.
Okay.
Don't matter. One team per round. Big Light said the Pelicans. We're going to call y'all out if y'all fucking lie.
We see some family checking out. Michael Jenkins is headed to the locker room. Appreciate you running through.
Appreciate that, fam. The talented Mr. Pick. You picked the Cavs already?
He said, I'm rocking out with the Cavs.
Already?
You can't pick them again.
So you're expecting them not to make it to the finals?
I guess that's the case.
Wow.
Somebody else is coming out of the East.
Wow. That's a hell of a... I mean, you jump right on that. Royal Blood said Dells, but I knew better. Houston Rockets. We know you're not going to waste that pick early. So Blood is going with the Rockets. And I know that hurt him to actually say the Rockets. But we appreciate you for playing. DreDay Kick. So we're picking the one team in the first round that you think will make it to the second round. The problem is that you pick this team once, you cannot pick them again. So if you pick the Wizards and you think the Wizards are going to the finals, you won't be able to pick the Wizards for the second round if they make it. So you have to pick another team. Jermaine Manning picked the Rockets. I'll go back and watch this shit.
Well, now that the chat posts, you should be able to.
Yeah, should be able to go back and catch it without a problem.
Information as well.
Dre is picking the Cavs as well. Y'all some disrespectful motherfuckers. Peace out, talented mister. All right.
Let's go Heat.
Somebody. One of us is out.
So Dubai says Celtics.
Celts. That's what's up. That's all the people that's playing. Y'all feel free to post it out later. You know what I'm saying?
You must be gone. I can't surprise she. I'm surprised she didn't make a pick.
Or, you know, she got to get them gangs. She probably headed to the gym or something. Mm. We appreciate QdaQueen. We're going to get her back on here this season, I think, too. We'll figure out the episode and let y'all know. And we're also working on something else that y'all might really like and appreciate. We got 5 minutes left. Y'all want to just kick it to the chat?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, let's do that.
Chat, if y'all got questions that y'all want us to talk to. I know. I just said I was going to the chat. Who you buzzing? I just said I was going to the chat. Motherfucker, you fired. So if y'all have anything y'all want us to talk about, some topics, some questions on your mind, if it's a shoe y'all think y'all want to hear us talk about, let us know. Sold to my soul, say Pelicans.
Yeah, Pelicans, sold to my soul.
Pelicans got 3 picks. Brian is playing with a pickup game crew. You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
QdaQueen, we need to get your pick on deck so we can know if we're going to hear you or not hear you the second round. Mm. Pick one team that you can't pick again that you think will win their first round matchup.
So people are asking, let me see, DreDay and Warrior Blood ask about the homage to home, the psychedelic ones, or
the Harvey, the two faces.
Yeah, the two-faced ones. There you go.
We got to see Unbreakable Kicks and Damn D. They were out in Chicago for that release, Fine Line. They were all out there for that release. My feelings are unchanged. It's an interesting shoe. It's not one that I would need, and it would be good for the flip. I don't think I'm even going to bother with the bullshit.
Q said
it's not a shoe that I'm really interested in. Q got the Rockets. Okay. But it's not a shoe I'm interested in.
It's intriguing, but if I gotta be totally 100% honest, it's flippable. That's all it is. It's not, and I have no interest in having a shoe for having.
They said he need that assist for those.
Okay, DreDay Kicks is on the assist for that. He could care less if it's numbered. Yeah, I get you on that. What do you think about Nike getting on the shops about the numbered pairs of homage to home? You have to give me more info on that with Jermaine Manning. I'm not really sure what happened on that.
The talented Mr. ask about the prom nights. I'm actually with that. I guess I'm probably in the minority, but unless I just see them in hand and they look really, really garbagey, I'm good. I'm with them. They're on my list.
Jumping back to the previous topic, Warrior Blood said that some shops were backdooring those. Nike called to verify stock, and people had to send them back to keep their jobs. Wow. Mm. Props to Nike for getting in on that. I like that.
You like that. You like that.
Man, good shit. The prom nights, slow burn for me. At first, I was out on them, and the more I see, that black is a deep-ass Wakanda black. Them look kind of dope. I'm not going to lie. Those look kind of dope. I think the price tag is $250, so I don't know if I'm in on that. But this it's a good-looking shoe.
And I think doesn't it have suede where they
– Yep.
Ballistic mesh.
Hey, so, man, look. When I go to Kadi's wedding, if I get those are on feet. Yeah. Let you know now, Kadi. Those are on feet if I get those. What about you, Kadi? You like those?
Well, hold up. DreDay is saying Unbreakable had to return his shoes.
Ooh. Breaking news.
Wow.
We're just saying what the chat is saying. We are not alleging.
Yes, no, exactly.
We don't know. We don't want no beef in these YouTube streets. That's just what we're Cadillac, do you want the tuxedo, the prom night's 11s? Yes or no?
Nah.
Kadillac Jackson, do you like the Raptor 4s? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Those are dope to me. The only slight gripe I have with those, I would have liked to seen the black charcoal, kind of like to give off that DMP7 look. But I can live with the black and the purple and the red. I'm cool with that. I think that shoe looks clean. Those, I get a chance at them. Those are coming home.
I'm coming home. I'm good. OG?
It's a maybe. It's a maybe. I'm, you know, I like 4's and I like purple, so it's on my street.
That's a win. Anybody else? What else they got in here? They went DMP with them. It would have been ill. That would have been a nice DMP pack. That would have been a real nice DMP pack. I still would have bought it, but it would have looked nice. Two pair Raptor 4's. DreDay kicks. You can't have every damn shoe that come out.
Warrior Blood said the colored ones, the green, yellow, red, and blue.
The 6-ring pack. I'm a sucker for 1's. I do like the blue pair, the blue, black, and white pair. I don't know that I'm going to pick them up, but I do like them. I'm good on the rest of them. I really dislike the red ones. Like, I don't like the red ones at all. The yellow and green are cool. The blue ones I think are dope.
Yeah, I don't like the suede. I'm not with that. I don't like any of them.
I like the yellow ones the best. I like the yellow ones. The blue is meh. I'll tell you what messed me up on the blue. I watched Mr. Orchard Beach's video of his custom Royal. Yeah, the custom frags he had done messed me all up.
Oh, because you're saying the frags look better.
Yeah.
But the blue is different, right? It's like more of a
the blue is different. The blue is like a more faded.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's suede.
It'll match my shirt.
It's a little lighter than that. Yeah, it's like more of that periwinkle.
I don't know. I definitely want to see them in hand, but I'm probably gonna pass on most of them. I mean, it's another one. I don't necessarily have to have it. I think the only other ones I'm looking for are the shattered backboards, and the.
Oh my goodness!
Wait a minute! Well, look who got out of all probation.
What happened? Who made it to the show?
Good, kicks oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen. Feast Kicks,
welcome to the show. You bastard, the show's over. Thanks for coming by. All you get left is the cold ass left out all day without the cover on it. Potato salad, we're not going to tell you who made it. You just go ahead and take this plate.
Karen made it. with the raisins. With the raisins. And a little bit of salt.
What's going on, V?
You just abandoned us.
Yeah.
Why she don't want me?
We leave you the horrible potato salad, the cold piece of chicken, not even a big piece of chicken. We leaving you that piece of chicken that was broken off that somebody done pulled pieces off of. You get that piece. And
it's sitting in the grease.
Mm-hmm. You get that piece, the one that somebody done pulled the skin off the top of it because they like skin. You getting that piece. Mm. You getting the half-eaten biscuit that Junior didn't want. And you get in the bottom of the Kool-Aid, not even the full glass. You get in that bottom where it's just all sugary.
All right, I think that's all the questions from the chat.
And you still ain't shit.
I think that's all the questions from the chat. We want to thank y'all again for rocking with us. I'm gonna go ahead and sign off first since I'm not the pastor anymore. I don't need to stick around for this church. I'm gonna leave so I can get out before the traffic. So it's your man Beard Jedi, a.k.a. the Black Alice P. Keaton, a.k.a. Shupak Shakur, a.k.a. I used to have a church, a.k.a. Deacon with no flock, a.k.a. Bishop Bilo, a.k.a. Jack Swagless, a.k.a. I'm out. Bastards.
As always, family, much love to y'all. It's your boy Kadillac Jackson. See y'all next week. Don't worry about the unofficial pastor. I kick it over to the elder.
We appreciate all the family who have come true tonight. You done know it's your boy OGSneekerz wishing all of you total sneaker family one love.
There is a rumor from the Talkin Kicks creative director that there is a shirt in the works. Start saving your coins for pre-orders. Y'all know how this works. If we don't get enough pre-orders, ain't shit being ordered. That's pretty much how it works. So y'all know what it is. I heard this from a source that there might be a shirt in the works. And that's all I can give you on that. That's all I can say. We out.
We out.
I'm rich, bitch.